And if you've been watching my words, you know I'm very serious about this matter. I'm very particular and very conscious of my words on this matter. When Jesus wanted crown, he didn't pray about crown, he don't perform miracle crown king. But when he wanted to choose apostles, the Bible said he continued all night. He prayed throughout the night to be able to choose 12. Amen. And so it is not an ordinary thing. Today, this house will be opening its hands to receive this man of God that God has just ordained. And as you receive him, every prophet, every servant of God has a special blessing. The reason why we have to formally receive it, that his blessing might rest upon our hearts. Are you getting it? Now, church, I want us to rise up to our feet. Kindly rise up to your feet as the one whom God has ordained to join us. He has been anointed by our general overseer. After our general overseer had been ordained as a bishop. So the first ordination after his bishopric ordination was this ordination, which makes it very unique. And our beloved was ordained as an assistant pastor, instructor, evangelical, as well. So brethren, join me as I welcome assistant pastor Oladele Simeon Adeyemo. Can you come forward and stay here? Come here, smile. Stand beside your husband. No, you will stand at this side. Daddy knows to be children. Is that not how to stand? Yes. So that you, they say you hold sword with this hand. In case something is coming, you will defend your wife with it. That is the idea. Hallelujah. That is why you to come and stand. Amen. Don't think that Sadie has not been ordained as pastor according to scripture by the later assembly. But there is a reason why she is standing here with her husband. Whatever a man is, his wife is. Do you know that? Do you know that? The wife is the pastor of the pastor. Are you hearing me? When you cast your body upon the pastor, the wife eventually bear the brunt. Amen. That is why the same anointing has to rest on both of them. Amen. Now, I present to the church God's servant, Pastor Oladele Simeon Adeyemo. Give the Lord a round of applause once again. But before he is formally introduced, you shall all pray for him. But before you pray for him, because after we have anointed him, he shall bless the church. Are you getting me now? But before we pray for him, under normal circumstances, I would have history with the work of God will prosper in his hand. That the work of God will prosper in their hands, not just his. That God will give them their heart of a pastor. the spirit of a pastor. They will operate as the ministers of God. Turn and face the altar. Yes, amen. I bless you today in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let the Spirit of the Lord come upon you. The power of the highest overshadow you. May you fulfill the ministry of God. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, it is well with you. In Jesus' name we pray. Only you sit down first. I want you to sit down. No, just relax. I'll call you back. Elder, come for me. No, face the altar. Face the altar. Amen. After that, no more anybody going there in Jesus' name. Amen. Anybody that God's spirit are connected, that you are now pastor. Hallelujah. Now I'm going, church, you can sit down. The Lord bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. I'm going to ask you a few questions. If you agree, you will say, yes, I do. Amen. Just a few, not as many as Gio's questions. Because you have been asked most of the questions in the headquarters. I'm going to just call you without any title. Now, I will ask you today before the congregation of God and before the Church of Christ and the family of God both in heaven and on earth, calling God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit as witness today, that are you willing to serve as an assistant pastor as you have been ordained, even in this denomination?
Yes, I do.
Are you willing? You are God.
Yes.
Are you willing to let go of all human pride and all that you would have called your own attainment, that you may be able to serve God and His children with all humility and with the help of the Holy Spirit?
Yes, I do. May God help.
Are you willing to do the work of the ministry even when it will be non-convenient and when it will be beyond your own strength, but totally depending on the strength of God? Will you be willing still to serve?
Yes, I do. God help me.
Will you be able to, will you be ready to serve the Lord's church with utmost love for God, with utmost commitment to His work, with utmost zeal for the work of the ministry?
Yes, I do. God help me.
Will you be willing to pray and intercede for the church of God?
Yes, I do. Go ahead.
Will you be willing to check on the sheep of God and ensure that everyone is in good standing with God and with their neighbors?
Yes, I do. Go ahead.
I want to start with the year.
Amen.
Will you depend on the Holy Spirit only for the work of the ministry?
Yes, I do. Go ahead.
Hallelujah. We have said this before the Lord. The Lord help you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You just hold his hand and bring him up to the pulpit. We bring you and accept you today into the service of God's work. You will not make mistakes. In the name of Jesus Christ. the mercy to be faithful. Faithful to God the Father who has called us. Faithful to the Christ, our governor. Faithful to the Church of Christ worldwide. Faithful to structure evangelical assembly worldwide. Faithful to the said man, our Lord the Bishop, Bishop Ralph Olufemi Olowo, according to the leading of the Holy Ghost. Faithful to us who have been in the ministry, and faithful to this congregation, the Lord give to you in the name of Jesus Christ. The hazard of ministry will not come near you. In the name of Jesus. The Lord put it in my spirit that I should call Papa to come and pray for him. Papa, come. Because the work that God has given to you, you are not starting early. Amen. It's not starting early. So he needs long life. So that he will be able to finish the work. Amen. Need our son. No, no, Papa, not you. Papa, you are going to lay hands on him, you are going to pray for him for long life. And listen. That he may be able to see the ministry. Lay hands on him and pray for him. Lay hands on his head, you are praying. If the last time you're going to lay hands on his head, he's going to lay hands on you as a son. So minister to him. Pray for him that God bless him with long life.
God the Father Almighty, your child is before you. He has been ordained as the pastor of this commission to take the responsibility of your work. With your infinite mercy, and lay hands on him with the authority from you, my Father. He has to live a long life as I lived as a long man. His generation will create one generation in his own life in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, for
telling
us.
As it has been said, I bless you today with long life. No matter how the enemy gather, they will not see you to perish. I prophesy concerning you, you shall not die before your time. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Every tongue that rises up against you in judgment is condemned. You will fulfill your ministry. Money started at the age of 80, yet he fulfilled his ministry, he lived to be 120. The Lord support you with long life. You will totally fulfill your ministry.
Amen.
Your life will not be cut short.
Amen.
I bless you today with wisdom.
Amen.
You will lead the sheep of God with wisdom.
Amen.
You will grow in wisdom.
Amen.
You will excel in wisdom.
Amen.
Every step you take will be taken in wisdom.
Amen.
I bless you with the gift of faith.
Amen.
You will pray and there will be results.
Amen.
Testimonies you will hear.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I bless your tongue today with the fire of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Whatsoever you say, you will see.
Amen.
Whatever you decree, you will see.
Amen.
The Lord will strengthen you with power.
Amen.
It is well with you.
Amen.
Hold him by this other side. Let's pull him up. Papa, hold him by your other hand. Let's pull him up. As you rise up today, you rise up into glory.
Amen.
You rise up into prosperity.
Amen.
You will not do ministry with poverty.
Amen.
I command prosperity to rest upon you.
Amen.
Anointing with prosperity is yours.
Amen.
Anointing with glory is yours.
Amen.
Your ministry is synonymous with glory.
Amen.
Your ministry is synonymous with power.
Amen.
Your ministry is synonymous with testimony.
Amen.
You take will be led by the Holy Ghost. God lead you with his word. God lead you with his voice. God lead you with his countenance. God lead you with his eyes. God lead you with circumstances. Receive sensitivity to the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus. Mama, please come forward. Now it's your turn. Come here, man. possible. Just if I walk, I just sleep on the Holy Ghost. Rakatalabaya Nabalabaya. Power of the Holy Ghost. The power of the Holy Ghost. Because you need sustenance. Please help me, help with that. Rakoto Shende Lebalabaya. Ekala da da la bra da la baya. Mokobre de gesimono da baranda la bra da balanda yaraba. Ekelebo subre de balabayande. Mata la baya. Every esco, I mean every worker, please come forward. Come forward. Every worker. Stand up, let's go. Melebronobo subre de balabaye de leboche. Ekanda yalada da da la baya. This is not an ordinary time. Pastor, keep praying in the Holy Ghost. Keep praying as the Lord give you whatever the Lord, whatever you want to ask God now. How you want your ministry to look like, talk to God about it. In fact, all the workers, come and join hands with the pastor. All of you, join hands. Come on. Join up with all of you. Just make sure that you are all joining. You can also touch. The link is not, you know, don't let it break. You can hold it exactly. Good. Reketalo bodo bada lala mono shente lebra namazande. Rekete balaba. You are interceding for them. You are interceding. Let the fire catch this circle. This circle. Everybody in the circle catches the fire. Predekese protalabayanda. Mekele dekesende leboyanda ba. Ragada labayanda labayanda. Lekeke sundo. Pray. Aha. Yes, let the fire of God fall upon this altar. Let everyone here receive fire. Bete lo coste. Bete le costa. Mata la boto brekete le be. Riate ke supra da lipo tolobanda yaraba. Yes, Lord Jesus. Aha. 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 Emtimo sekdebra nanda yaraba boste nebosh. Yes, Lord Jesus. So, everyone, apart from ESCO meetings in the church, it is Pastor Oladile Adeyemo. Or how do you prefer it? Adeyemo, Pastor Oladile, which one do you prefer? Okay, I prefer Pastor Adeyemo. I think it's better. Or simply Pastor. Pastor Adeyemo. But someone say Pastor Eda. But that Eda, I don't think. There is promotion. Pastor Adeyemo. Amen. Praise the Lord Jesus Christ. So, I've already told you, I've told the church how he's ordained over there, Assistant Pastor Oladile Adeyemo. Now, I'm presenting to you Pastor Oladile Adeyemo. Give the Lord a round of applause. Now, this is the reason why I brought him here. He's going to be anointed in the midst of his brethren. Hallelujah. We are his brethren, right? We are going to anoint him. If you have a camera you want to snap, you can snap. God like you, everything just new. New bishop or new pastor, and we are using new oil to receive him. I know everything just new about him. Do you notice it? It's a new season for you in Jesus. They are over in the name of Jesus. The new things you have been desiring, you have started experiencing them in the name of Jesus. With this anointing, all things have become new in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Please go on your knees for the anointing.
Everything is new. I anoint you today in the name of the Father,
amen.
And of the Son,
amen.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I bring you today to the function of God in this assembly.
You will not fail God.
Amen.
All the power and the anointing that you need to function properly,
receive it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God told me that He has ordained you as a catalyst for the growth of this church.
Receive the power in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
When you invite people, they will not be able to resist.
Amen.
When you disciple people, they will grow.
Amen.
When you talk to people, they will hear.
Amen.
One day God told me, say, I give you a tongue of fire. Today I give you a tongue of fire.
Amen.
No problem will be able to withstand your tongue. Whatever stand before you will dissolve when you speak.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. And I give God give to me, I give to you, I give you the sword of fire. Not to be able to resist you. You will dissolve doubt. You will dissolve problems. You will bring down mountains. You will exalt the name of God. In the name of Jesus Christ. You are living before God. You will not live before men. You will not beg to eat. You will lend to nations. Kings shall lend wisdom at your lips. Princes shall come out of your loins. In the name of Jesus. The Lord gives you this land. The Lord gives you the land of Ejigbo. The Lord gives you the land of Lagos. The Lord gives you the land of Nigeria. The Lord gives you the land of Africa. The Lord opened the doors of the continent of the world to you. Yours is an international ministry. In the name of Jesus Christ, it is well with you. Rise up into glory.
Are you snapping? Amen. We are blessed in the name of the Father,
Amen.
And of the Son,
Amen.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
You are welcome to the Amen. Amen. Now we are now going to rejoice. Come on, shake it. Shake the new pastor. Shake the new pastor. Pastor. Amen. Yes. Yeah. Before we sing and then, but by the time he comes, before he leaves here, he's going to bless the church. Amen. Yes, so much is now the picture. Papa wants to see himself snapping with the pastor. But before we leave here, before the congregation leaves,
that's what I told God myself. I used to use glasses. Hallelujah. Now I no longer use glasses. I told God I'm not going to use glasses till I leave this room. Praise the Lord Jesus. Oh no, wait, I'm sorry. Someone is taking care of the children. Please, take care of my children, okay? The Lord bless you. Pastor is busy. Hallelujah. Okay, no problem. It's your day. Without option. Amen.
Even if the next thing goes up, they will put that.
Our children are our cameraman.
Isaiah 40 verse 4. He said, every principally shall be exalted. In every area you go to, wherever they look down on you, they shall be looking unto you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray that every mountain and hill shall be made low.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every mountain before you shall be made low.
Amen.
Every hill that you see before you come to this place, you shall see them no more.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray today, as God liveth, that what you see that you are crying on, from today, it will turn to joy for you.
Amen.
I pray today, as we are here, I pray in the mighty name of Jesus. By this time next year, this place will not be known for us.
Amen.
God has promised, and the reason why he called me is to take over the land of it. The land of Ejigbo will be taken over.
Amen.
He has said it, and his word does not change.
Yes.
I pray today, whatever that may be the hindrance that want to stand as often today, in the name that supersedes every other name, are taken away.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
God that removed Red Sea,
yes, Lord Jesus,
that stand before the Israelites without any stress. Moses does not fast. He does not pray. God just say he stresses his hand. I stand on this today. I stretch my hand, the hand of God Almighty, to every four corners of Ejigbo.
Yes.
And his environment.
Yes.
And Lagos as a whole.
Yes.
Any body, any soul that want to stand as a Red Sea, today they were removed.
Amen.
They dry up.
Amen.
As Red Sea dry, for the Israelite to move, it has never happened, but because it's God, on this Monday, God will prove himself.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray today, you that is here, you are the foundation member. By the time this prophecy comes to pass,